In part 3 of our lesson on radian measure, you're going to get experience finding trig function values for angles in radian measure. A quick reminder here that the reference angle is the acute angle formed between the terminal side of theta and the nearest x-axis. Now, to find trig function values, we're going to need a couple of charts that we've made earlier. The first is the chart for the trig values for the special angles. And in previous sections, we were using degrees, so 30 degrees, 45 degrees, and 60 degrees. But now we're going to be thinking in terms of radian measure. So the special angles are pi over 6, pi over 4, and pi over 3. Now remember, making this chart is as easy as 1, 2, 3. We put in the denominators of 2 and we add in the radicals. We know the cosine row is 3, 2, 1. And again, add in the radicals and the denominators of 2. And then for the tangent row, we just see the division, 1 over radical 3 is rad 3 over 3. See the division, so we get 1. See the division, we get radical 3. Next, we need our chart for the positive and negative signs of the trig functions based on their quadrants. Now, remembering that sine of theta is equal to y over r by definition, then we know that sine theta and its reciprocal, cosecant theta, will be positive whenever the y value is positive. So that's going to happen in quadrant 1 and quadrant 2. And sine theta and cosecant theta will be negative whenever the y value is negative, and that's in quadrants 3 and 4. We know cosine theta is defined to be x over r, so cosine and its reciprocal, secant, will be positive whenever the x value is positive. So that happens in quadrants 1 and 4. And cosine and secant will be negative whenever x is negative in quadrants 2 and 3. Tangent theta is defined to be y over x, and so tangent theta and its reciprocal, cotangent theta, will be positive whenever x and y have the same positive and negative sign, which happens in quadrants 1 and 3. Tangent and cotangent will be negative whenever x and y have opposite positive and negative signs, and that happens in quadrants 2 and 4. So this will be our toolkit for finding trig function values for angles in radian measure. We need to use reference angles. We'll need to use the chart for the trig values of special angles. And we'll need to use the chart for the positive and negative signs of the trig functions by quadrant. So let's get started. Now in this next example, we're going to find each value of the given trig functions. So here we have to find the cosine of 5 pi over 3. So we know step 1 is to draw a diagram of the angle. And we know that 5 pi over 3 lives in quadrant 4. Next, we have to determine the reference angle. And we know our nearest x-axis is here at 2 pi, which if we think of Having a denominator of 3, we can think of it as 6 pi over 3. So we know that from 5 pi over 3 to 6 pi over 3 means our reference angle is pi over 3. Next, we have to find the trig function value of our reference angle. And we know that the cosine of pi over 3 is equal to 1/2. Then step 4 says to determine the sine, the positive and negative sine. Now in quadrant 4, we know that cosine is positive. So then that means the cosine of 5 pi over 3 is going to be positive 1/2. This next one is tangent of 3 pi over 4. So go ahead and pause the video and try this one on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. We know the first step is to draw theta. 3 pi over 4 lives in quadrant 2. Second step is to find the reference angle. And we know the nearest x-axis is going to be here at pi. Now, getting the same denominator we have, which is 4, we know that pi is the same as 4 pi over 4. So our reference angle has to go from 3 pi over 4 to 4 pi over 4, which means that theta r is going to be pi over 4. Step 3 says to find the value for our trig function of theta r. We've got tangent, so we know the tangent of pi over 4 is equal to 1. Step 4, we have to determine the positive and negative sine, and we know that in quadrant 2, that tangent of theta is going to be negative. So when we put all that together, that means that the tangent of 3 pi over 4 is going to be negative 1. Next up, we have to find the sine of 7 pi over 6. So give that a try, pause the video, and restart when you're ready to check. First step is to draw theta. We know that 7 pi over 6 lives here in quadrant 3. The nearest x-axis is going to be here at pi. And we know if we write that with a denominator of 6, that is 6 pi over 6. So then that means our reference angle is going to be 7 pi over 6 minus 6 pi over 6, which is pi over 6. Step 3 is to evaluate the trig function of the reference angle. We know that the sine of pi over 6 on our special angle chart is equal to 1/2. Fourth step, determine the positive negative sine based on the quadrant. We're in quadrant 3, and in quadrant 3 we know that sine theta has to be negative. So putting those two pieces together, we know that the sine of 7 pi over 6 is going to be negative 1/2. Okay, go ahead and try cosine of negative 7 pi over 4. Stop the video and start it up again when you're ready to check. Negative 7 pi over 4 lives in quadrant 1. We know that the nearest x-axis will be here at negative 2 pi, which, if we give that a denominator of 4, is negative 8 pi over 4. To find our reference angle, we have negative 7 pi over 4 minus negative 8 pi over 4, and of course minus a negative turns into plus, so when we calculate that we get pi over 4. Step 3 says to evaluate the trig function at the reference angle, so cosine of pi over 4 is radical 2 over 2. Step 4 is to determine the positive and negative sign based on the quadrant. We're in quadrant 1, where we know cosine of theta is positive. So then that means the cosine of negative 7 pi over 4 is going to be positive radical 2 over 2. Next up, we have sine of negative 2 pi over 3. You're probably getting pretty good at this by now, so why don't you go ahead and try these next two examples? Pause the video, try them out, and then we'll check them both when you're ready. So we know that negative 2 pi over 3 lives here in quadrant 3. And the nearest x-axis is here at negative pi, and we'll want to think of that as negative 3 pi over 3, because our denominator is 3. So theta r is going from negative 2 pi over 3 to negative 3 pi over 3. So theta r is pi over 3. Find the trig function value of the reference angle, sine of pi over 3 off of our special angle chart is equal to radical 3 over 2. We know that in quadrant 3 that sine theta is going to be negative, so then that means that the sine of negative 2 pi over 3 is going to be negative radical 3 over 2. Five pi over 6 lives here in quadrant 2. We know that the nearest x-axis would be here at pi, and to give it a denominator of 6, we think of pi as 6 pi over 6. Our reference angle then is going to be between 5 pi over 6 and 6 pi over 6, so we know theta r is going to be pi over 6. Evaluate our trig function value there, so tangent of pi over 6 off the special angle chart is equal to radical 3 over 3. And finally, we have to evaluate the positive and negative sign based on the quadrant, and we know that in quadrant 2, tangent of theta is going to be negative. So that means Combining these two pieces together, we know that the tangent of 5 pi over 6 is going to be negative radical 3 over 3. This next example asks us to find each value, and first up is the cosecant of pi over 6. Now we know cosecant is not on our special angle chart, so we're going to use a reciprocal identity and write this as 1 over the sine of pi over 6. Now pi over 6, we know, lives in quadrant 1, and the quadrant 1 angles are our favorites because they are their own reference angles. So we know the reference angle is pi over 6. Looking on the special angle chart, we know that the sine of pi over 6 is equal to 1/2. So then that means that the cosecant of pi over 6 is equal to 2. The secant of pi over 4, using a reciprocal identity, we know is 1 divided by the cosine of pi over 4. Again, pi over 4 is in quadrant 1, so it is its own reference angle. Looking on the chart, we know that the cosine of pi over 4 is equal to radical 2 over 2. Simplifying, this becomes 2 over radical 2, and we have to rationalize. So we multiply by radical 2 over radical 2, and we get 2 radical 2 over 2. And of course, these 2's are going to cancel, and we're left with radical 2. So go ahead and try this next one on your own. Pause the video and restart it when you're ready to check your answer. Of course, we know cotangent is 1 over the tangent of pi over 3. Pi over 3, also in quadrant 1. So we know the reference angle is going to be pi over 3. The tangent of pi over 3 is radical 3. We're going to rationalize by multiplying by radical 3 over itself, and we get radical 3 over 3.